Hello, I'm Philip Stoughton for ID People. I'm here at ID World in Rio de Janeiro, and I'm joined by Terry Hartman from Unisys. Terry, thanks for stopping by to chat at the end of the event. It's been a very busy event. What have been your thoughts? What have been your takeaways, particularly with respect to the area of interest for Unisys?
Well, we have a lot of areas of interest around all aspects of integration of identity solutions. I think for me, the interest was a number of government people here and a number of people looking towards the future and looking beyond perhaps a single mode of biometric like fingerprint and saying, well, we need to think about how we can integrate other modes of identity into our solutions like iris, like facial recognition, and going beyond that simple step of what they've traditionally been using to this point in time.
It does seem that those kind of hybrid solutions are the way, and also, as you say, a lot of governments here, a lot of government and private partnerships seem to be the way to make these things work. What's Unisys' role in that? Is it the data side? Is it the provision of equipment?
Unisys' role is provision of solutions.
Right.
So the overall solution, integrating best practice and best of breed solutions to help those government or private financial services, transportation customers in particular with various solutions. There'll be industry solutions, there'll be government and public sector solutions, and there'll be mission critical application solutions. So identity is an enabler for that, but so are many other related solutions as well.
Okay, and Rio de Janeiro's got its own challenges coming up with the World Cup next year, the Olympics in 3 years' time, lots going on there. But what are you seeing elsewhere in terms of regional variation in how ID is applied?
When you look at the developing nations, you look at Latin America, you look at Africa, there's a lot of focus on empowering people with the right to exercise their identity. And that's quite a fundamental shift because many people don't have documentation, they don't have birth certificates, and in today's world they want to be able to exercise that right and say, now I need to get these services. As developing countries become more advanced, they need to be able to lend people money, they need to be able to provide them, and they need collateral in. And how do you prove you have collateral? You can't say, well, I've always lived on this block of land. You need something that identifies you and can associate title or whatever to that particular loan you're going after or whatever. So that whole right of proving I am me and proving next time I'm me as well is what's driving a lot of this revolution in developing nations, along with the need to be keeping up with modern technology and getting exposed to modern technology. One of the amazing things we've really seen this year is for the first time biometrics is going to be in the hands of millions of consumers who have never had a reason to think about it before, with the iPhone 5S. And that's going to change, in a lot of ways, people's attitudes to identity, to biometrics, to the use of it, and to how it can protect your identity.
Yeah, it's interesting that there's this variation between the developed world and the less developed world. In the developed world, we seem to be more concerned with the privacy we're giving up, and in the developing world, it's more about the opportunities they're developing. Do you think the developed regions can learn from these new regions?
They can learn a lot, because the new regions, as I said, look at identity for different ways and in different reasons. And the developed world tends to think, oh, this is a new problem, and forget that you can go and do name searches on the internet and find out enormous amounts of information about people. So by protecting and corralling that information a little bit better and a little bit differently, it actually enables you to then protect your privacy in many ways. So that's a very important outcome that's coming from a lot of these things, as is the ability to start to risk profile what you do, to associate levels of risk with transactions you want to undertake, and to underpin all of that with much stronger identity.
Yeah, absolutely. And I guess we need to look at it as empowering rather than debilitating, and that's the key, isn't it?
Exactly.
Terry, thank you very much for your time. Thanks for taking part this week. It's been a pleasure, and I hope we can talk again soon. Thank you.
No, thank you. Great talking to you.